Hi, it's Tahir here. And so in today's lesson, I will walk you guys through how we can create a Trello board for the purpose of managing your IT projects. So stay tuned. Okay, so firstly, I will talk to you something about Agile development. So there are two strategies for implementing an Agile development, which is Kanban or Scrum, and each depends on the project. You may use one of them, or you can use one but implementing some features of the other. But I will walk you through the kind of main difference that you can choose which one you will go with. So first, regarding Scrum, you need to divide the task into sprints, which will last around 2 to 4 weeks. Normally when planning for Scrum, a sprint in Scrum, you need to have like all the tasks prepared for the sprint, and change is not encouraged when implementing in the sprint. So so that is how Scrum work. And for Kanban, you don't need to have things planned ahead, so you can have tasks just created, and the developers can work on them immediately, and you don't need to divide things into sprint. Okay, so the Trello board would be different. And so now I will teach you guys how you can create a Kanban project. Okay, so now you head to Trello, and after you has signed in and click the board here, you will see that the templates are already showing here, and you click to Kanban template in order to start a Kanban board. And here you click the create board from template and name it the same as your app. And here, okay, so you can keep the card or start from scratch, and in this case I will keep the cards. Okay, so after I have create a Trello board, so this is what it look like. You can start manipulate all the tickets on here. Okay, so now first you need to add the team member to this board. You can insert the email. Okay, so for example, I insert my email here, and it will send a link and send invitation, or you can create a link and you sync this link and send to your team for them to access this board. Okay, so this is how you add the team. Next, I will walk you through the what do we have here. So we have the first column, which is the backlog. So in the backlog, you will have the car that are not ready to be worked on yet. It can be some the epic, which only have like the idea, but it cannot be implemented yet. So for that, you will put it here. Okay, they're not ready for work, but high likelihood of being worked on. Okay, so next you have the design. So the design is for the designer in the project. So he can look at here and see which component that he should work on, because the design part is separate from the coding. So next we have the to-do. Okay, so for to-do is the to-do column would include all the tickets that need to be worked on, and it also has priority attached to the car. For example, if I say to do 2, to do 3, the dev will know that the this one because it is organized above those two. So this one is more urgent and is more highly prioritized than the rest. Okay, next we have doing. So when a dev decide to work on this card, they will move the card from here to doing here to let the team know that he is working on this ticket. Yeah, so after he has done this one, he will put to the code review here, and in the code review normally there would be a technical lead who will take a look and review the code to make sure that it is it adheres to the best practice in software development. And after the review, if everything passed, he will deploy it to the site and so that the QC can start testing. Okay, so after that, the QC, when they start the testing process of a task, they would move the ticket here to the testing to let the team know that this card is being tested by the QC and QA engineer. Okay, and after the testing had been done, he can move to the done here to let everyone know that this task has been fully tested. Okay, so this one is a very simple and easy to use board. But in my opinion, I think that this one is only for the project that hasn't been released yet. So this board is only used for internal, and there is no beta tester. There is no actual end user who tests on this one. If that's the case, we can use this board. But in my work, normally I would use more than that because this one doesn't cover all the aspects that I'm going to mention here. Okay, so now I will mention about, for example, in the middle of the implementation, the customer decided that they want to have like beta tester or the actual end user who will use the application and to report the issue and the bugs, or they want to have any feedbacks on how to improve the application. And that's when this template is starting to become obsolete, because you can just deploy the feature directly to the end user without fully testing, fully being tested. So you need more column in order to handle this case. So the first one here that need to be simple staging. Okay, so first after the developers, they have reviewed the code, and they will deploy that into the staging environment. So to let you know that staging is the environment that is mainly used for QC and QA engineer for the testing purpose, and say the end user will not use this environment. So this is staging, and after they have done the review, they will put the card to staging and deploy the code to staging. And when the QC started to test this feature, he will put it on testing. I will change this one to testing on staging. Okay, and so after testing on staging, the developers need to deploy this ticket to the live environment. So the live is when the end user actually use with the features that have been tested. And I will need two columns here, which is ready for live. Or this one you can say something like testing. So after the testing, they will put it here. And for example, after a week, the dev will collect all these tickets and deploy once on the live site. So after, for example, they have tested these two and they are ready to go on live. And when the developers, they deploy these two tickets on the live environment, they will put a card in the live here. Okay. And also, if the customer require you to test on the live environment also, you will need to put the testing on live here. Okay. And the QC will need to put the code, put the task that they need to test it on the live environment here. And for example, if the testing is successful, they will put it on the done. And this is the final column, which lets everyone know that this card has been tested fully. But I will also need a review bar. This one will be placed before the done. So when you put on the done and the customer review the done card, and they, for example, they see that okay, so there is still bugs that the QC and QA engineer hasn't caught yet, they will put it back to review to let everyone know that there are still bugs in the ticket that need to be fixed. And so from here, the dev will put them back to doing and start to restart the process. Okay. Yeah. So this is how the Kanban board look like. It's very suitable if you are working on a project that needs continuous improvement and feedback from customer and the end user. Yeah, and normally I would use this one more than the Scrum board, because in order to do the Scrum, you need to plan everything from two to four weeks ahead and carefully plan out the thing before implementing each sprint. So yeah, so this is how a Kanban look like. I will do a Scrum board later, so stay tuned. And in the next video, I will teach you guys how you can create a ticket and from and put the requirement in the ticket. So yeah, so see you in the next video. Bye.